Hello everybody, I am Walmart Killer, and today I'm going to be making some beef jerky. Now, for this beef jerky, there's only a couple key main ingredients you want to keep in mind. One thing I want to put in here is 1 teaspoon, right here, 1 teaspoon of Tenderquick, Morton's Tenderquick. I don't want to be making any more in there than that. That should be just enough. Now, for the rest of these ingredients, this is just going to be stuff that I'm just throwing together. Why not? Some Kikkoman soy sauce, I'll pour some of that in there, just dump a generous amount, why not? Soy sauce. This is going to be for, what was that? About 4.5, almost 4 pounds of meat, something like that. And we'll put some ketchup in there. That's bad boys. Ketchup, why not? And let's see here. Ooh, this is going to be good. Sweet Baby Ray's sweet and spicy barbecue sauce. Oh yeah. I'm looking forward to this one. Add a bunch of that in there. Generous amount. More like that. There we go. Let's see here. Some Worcestershire sauce. Again, we'll just try to get as much of that in there as we can. There we go. Alright. Some Sriracha chili sauce. This stuff's delicious. It's not that hot, but it's very delicious. If you want hot, use hotter sauce. Just pour a whole bunch of that in there, why not? Okay. And let's see here. Just some Kikkoman sweet and sour. I've had this laying around for a while and I figured, why not? Some sweet and sour in that bad boy. Not much here, really. That's about all that. Okay. I don't know where you can get this next ingredient at. You might be able to buy it online at Shields. They have an online site if you don't have a Shields in your place. Otherwise, it is Smokin' Gun Jerky Marinade. Now, really, you could just get away with just using this and maybe a couple other key ingredients, but I'm not going to use as much as I normally use this time. This is really more for the cure itself because it has stuff in it for the cure. And while we're speaking of that, make sure you always shake it up. Shake it up a little bit. I'm going to add this to it. Let's see how much we should put in there. I don't know. Probably like that much. I don't know. Whatever. And let's see here. We're going to add one other key ingredient. And I've never done this before. I've added other stuff. Don't actually have enough. We're going to add some sugar. Just a regular old table sugar. Alright, we're going to add more sugar. That should be enough. That's plenty. I don't want to add too much and go nuts. Put your excess sugar in there. Alright, so now we're going to mix all this crap up. Get a good spoon in there. Something to get on all the sides. Spatula would be great. Gotta have a spatula. Alright, so we're gonna stir this crap all up. Might have to use the blender. Now you can always tell if it's gonna be good if you can taste this, like sample it, and see what it tastes like. And if it tastes good, that flavor is probably just gonna get magnified in the meat. And yeah. That's what you want. Magnify that flavor in the meat. I got just some basic, I got some rant, some round meat, some of that. And then I went with some rib meat. And I got it freezing in the freezer right now, so I can slice it up all nice and neat. And that would be super delicious. Let's give that a taste. Oh my god, is that actually going to be super good. Alright.
I wonder if that's enough sauce. But you get the idea. And just slice up your meat to about, you know, oh, quarter of an inch thick or so. Throw the meat in here after it's thawed up a little bit, because I like to keep mine frozen, you know, so you can slice it up. Not frozen solid all the way, but frozen enough. Throw it in here with this crap, and I'll end up mixing it all up thoroughly. Put it in a Ziploc bag and let it sit for, I don't know, a day, 2 days, probably 2 days would be best. Let it sit for 2 days, and then throw it in your dehydrator, smoker, whatever it is you're going to do in order to dry it out, and you should have some super, super, super delicious meat. I will show you the meat after I got it all in there in the bag, and then I'll also show you the meat after it gets done. Like, when I put it in the dehydrator, I'll show you that, and I'll also show you the final product. So, as you see right now, this is the finished product here. Not finished, but product with all the good delicious sauce and stuff on it. Just rotating it around now. It's been sitting for only, oh god, that smells great. Sitting for only about, I don't know, 8 hours in the bag. I'm gonna let this stuff marinate until at least Christmas Day. And then, you know, do my thing. Dehydrate the crap out of it, so I'll get back to you then. Alright, this is the meat after I've been dehydrating it for about 4 hours. I gotta admit, I made some of these a little thicker than intended. But other ones I cut, you know, just about right. Oh man, that's delicious. If I had to do it again, I'd do the same thing. Or maybe add some pepper, just a little bit of pepper. Mmm, god, that's good. As you can see, zoom in, will you? There's my settings. And I have the Nesco dehydrator. Only way to turn it on and off is to plug or unplug it. And that's about almost 5 pounds of meat. And I got it set up right here. All my trays are stacked up. But it's a total success. This is super good. Like I said, next time I'll just add maybe some pepper. Maybe not. It's actually pretty damn good just like this. And this is it, the finished product. Let's see here. Some of these pieces were crazy thick here. Look how thick that is. But they all dehydrated just fine. Took a long time for some of the bigger pieces, but they turned out really, really good. Really well. And yeah, it's super tasty. If anything, I think next time when I make this, I'm going to add some black pepper, but just throw everything else in it like I did this time. Anyways, super delicious. Yeah, go ahead and try it yourself. Thanks. Mmm, that's good stuff. Later.